We are going to study about solutions. A solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Lemonade, soda water, etc. are all examples of solutions. In a solution, there is a homogeneity at the particle level. For example, lemonade tastes the same throughout. This shows that particles of sugar or salt are evenly distributed in the solution. A solution has a solvent and a solute as its components. The component of the solution that dissolves the other component in it, usually the component present in larger amount, is called the solvent. The component of the solution that is dissolved in the solvent, usually present in lesser quantity, is called the solute. Examples: a solution of sugar in water is a solid in liquid solution. In this solution, sugar is the solute and water is the solvent. Second example, a solution of iodine in alcohol, known as tincture of iodine, has iodine solid as the solute and alcohol liquid as the solvent. Third example, drinks like soda water, etc. are gas in liquid solutions. These contain carbon dioxide gas as solute and water liquid as solvent. Another example, air is a mixture of gas in gas. Air is a homogeneous mixture of a number of gases. Its two main constituents are oxygen 21%, nitrogen 78%, and other gases are present in very small quantities. Properties: a solution is a homogeneous mixture. The particles of a solution are smaller than 1 nm in diameter, so they cannot be seen by naked eyes. Because of very small particle size, they do not scatter a beam of light passing through the solution. So, the path of light is not visible in a solution. The solute particles cannot be separated from the mixture by the process of filtration. The solute particles do not settle down when left undisturbed, that is, a solution is stable. Types of solutions. Many commonly encountered solutions are those involving a solid that has been dissolved in a liquid. But there are so many types of solutions as there are different combinations of solids, liquids, and gases. Solutions in which the solvent is a liquid and the solute is a gas, liquid, or solid are very common. The atmosphere is a good example of a solution in which a gaseous solvent, nitrogen, dissolves other gases such as oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, and neon. Solutions of solids in solids are another example, and these are encountered most often among the various metal alloys. Of all the liquid solvents used in the laboratory, in industry, and in the home, water is the most commonly employed and is the best of the inorganic solvents. The alcohols and numerous other types of compounds are classified as organic solvents. Many of these are used in dry cleaning chemicals, nail polish removers, paint thinners, and many other similar purposes. Solvents can be gases, liquids, or solids. One or more components present in the solution other than the solvent are called solutes. The solution has the same physical state as the solvent. Gas. If the solvent is a gas, only gases are dissolved under a given set of conditions. An example of a gaseous solution is air, oxygen and other gases dissolved in nitrogen. Since interactions between molecules play almost no role, dilute gases form rather trivial solutions. Liquid. If the solvent is a liquid, then gases, liquids and solids can be dissolved. Examples are gas in liquid, oxygen in water. Carbon dioxide in water is a less simple example because the solution is accompanied by a chemical reaction, formation of ions. Note also that the visible bubbles in carbonated water are not the dissolved gas but only an effervescence of carbon dioxide that has come out of solution. The dissolved gas itself is not visible since it is dissolved on a molecular level. Liquid in liquid. The mixing of two or more substances of the same chemistry but different concentration to form a constant. Homogenization of solutions. Alcoholic beverages are basically solutions of ethanol in water. Solid in liquid. Sucrose, table sugar in water. Sodium chloride or any other salt in water form an electrolyte. When dissolving, salt dissociate into ions. Counter examples are provided by liquid mixtures that are not homogeneous. Colloids, suspensions, emulsions are not considered solutions. Body fluids are example for complex liquid solutions containing many different solutes. They are electrolytes since they contain solute ions. Example, potassium and sodium. Furthermore, they contain solute molecules like sugar and urea. Oxygen and carbon dioxide are also essential components of blood chemistry, where significant changes in their concentrations can be a sign of illness or injury. Solid. If the solvent is a solid, then gases, liquids and solids can be dissolved. Gas in solid. Hydrogen dissolves rather well in metals, especially in palladium. This is studied as a means of hydrogen storage. Liquid in solid. Mercury in gold forming an amalgam. Hexane in paraffin wax. Solid in solid. Steel. Basically a solution of carbon atoms in a crystalline matrix of iron atoms, alloys like bronze and many others, polymers containing plasticizers. Here is some examples of types of solutions and their common examples in daily life. Gaseous solutions, liquid solutions, solid solutions. Expressing concentrations of solutions. Concentration of a solution refers to the amount of solute present in the given quantity of solution or solvent. Concentration of solution means describing its composition. Ways to describe the concentration of solution. First, mass percentage. Second, volume percentage. And third, mass by volume percentage. Fourth, parts per million, ppm. Five, mole fraction, mass percentage. It is defined as the number of parts by mass of solute per 100 parts by mass of solution. Mass percentage is equal to mass of the component divided by total mass of solution multiplied by 100. Volume percentage. It is defined as the number of parts by volume of solute per 100 parts by volume of solution. Volume percentage is equal to volume of the component divided by total volume of solution into 100. Mass by volume percentage. Mass of solute dissolved in 100 milliliter of the solution. Parts per million. It is defined as the number of parts by mass of solute per million parts by mass of the solution. Parts per million is equal to number of parts of the component divided by total number of parts of all component into 10 lakh. Mole fraction. Mole fraction is defined as the ratio of number of moles of one component to the total number of moles of all the component present in the solution. Mole fraction of a component is equal to number of moles of the component divided by total number of moles of all the components. Solubility. Solubility of a substance is its maximum amount that can be dissolved in a specified amount of solvent. Solubility depends upon the nature of solute and solvent as well as the condition of temperature and pressure. Solubility of a solid in a liquid. The dissolved solute particles also collide with solid solute and some of them separate out of solution and get deposited these. This process is called crystallization. Solubility of a solid solute in a liquid depend upon the following factors. First, nature of solute. Dissolution of solid solute in liquids can be summed up in a phrase like dissolved like. This means that polar solutes dissolves in polar solvents and non-polar solutes dissolves in non-polar solvents. Second, temperature. If the value of delta sol H less than 0, that is the solution process is exothermic, then by Lee Cattelier's principle, the pressure. Pressure does not have any significant effect on solubility of solids in liquids. It is so because solids and liquids are highly incompressible and practically remain unaffected by changes in pressure. Solubility of a gas in a liquid. When a gas is passed through the liquid solvent, the gas particles dissolves in liquid. The concentration of the solution gradually increases till the equilibrium point is reached and a saturated solution is obtained. Factors affecting the solubility of gases. First, the nature of the gas. In general, the gases which are easily liquefy are relatively more soluble in common solvent. Second, effect of temperature. the solubilities of most of gases in water diminishes with the rise in temperature because their dissolution process are exothermic. Third, effect of pressure, Henry's law. The solubility of gases vary appreciably with variation in pressure. Increasing the pressure of gas above the solution increases its solubility. Henry's law. When dissolving gases in liquids, the pressure has an important effect on the solubility. William Henry, an English chemist, showed that the solubility of a gas increased with increasing pressure. Vapor pressure of liquid solutions. Liquid solutions are formed when solvent is a liquid. The solute can be a gas, a liquid, or a solid. We shall discuss the solution of liquids and solids in a liquid. Such solutions may contain one or more volatile components. We shall discuss the properties of only binary solutions, that is the solutions containing two components, namely the solutions of liquid in liquid and solid in liquids. Vapor pressure of liquid to liquid solutions. Consider binary solution of two volatile liquids and denote the two components as 1 and 2. When taken in a closed vessel, both the components would evaporate and eventually an equilibrium would be established between vapor phase and the liquid phase. The total vapor pressure at this stage be P total and P1 and P2 be the partial vapor pressure of the two components 1 and 2 respectively.
These partial pressures are related to the mole fractions X1 and X2 of the two components 1 and 2. The French chemist Raoult gave the quantitative relationship between them. The relationship is known as the Raoult's law, which states that for a solution of volatile liquids, the partial vapor pressure of each component in the solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Thus, for component 1, P1 is directly proportional to X1 and P1 is equal to P1 degree X1, where P1 degree is the vapor pressure of pure component 1 at the same temperature. Similarly, for component 2, P2 is equal to P2 degree X2, where P2 degree represents the vapor pressure of the pure component 2. According to Dalton's law of partial pressure, the total pressure P total over non-ideal solution. A non-ideal solution is a solution that does not abide to the rules of an ideal solution, where the interactions between molecules are identical or very close to the interactions between molecules of different components. That is, there is no forces acting between the components. No van der Waal nor any Coulomb forces. Non-ideal solutions can occur in two ways. First, when intermolecular forces between the solute and solvent Colligative properties. There are four colligative properties of solutions that you should know. First, vapor pressure. Second, boiling point elevation. Third, freezing point depression. Fourth, osmotic pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. Raoult established that the lowering of vapor pressure depends only on the concentration of the solute particles and it is independent of their identity. A relation between vapor pressure of the solution, mole fraction and vapor pressure of the solvent, that is P1 is equal to X1 P1 dash. Elevation of boiling point. Boiling point elevation occurs when the boiling point of a solution becomes higher than the boiling point of a pure solvent. The temperature at which the solvent boils is increased by adding any non-volatile solute. Boiling point elevation, like freezing point depression, is a colligative property of matter. This means it depends on the number of particles present in a solution and not on the type of particles or their mass. Let TB0 be the boiling point of pure solvent and TB be the boiling point of solution. The increase in the boiling point del TB is equal to TB minus TB0 is known as elevation of boiling point. Experiments have shown that the dilute solutions, the elevation of boiling point del TB is directly proportional to the molar concentration of the solute in a solution. Thus, del TB is directly proportional to M. Del TB is equal to KB into M. Here, M molality is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 kilogram of solvent, and the constant of proportionality KB is called boiling point elevation constant or molar elevation constant. If W2 gram of solute of molar mass M2 is dissolved in W1 gram of solvent, then molality M of the solution is given by the expression M is equal to W2 upon M2 whole divided by W1 upon 1000, which is equal to 1000 into W2 upon M2 into W1. Substituting the value of molality in equation 1, we get del TB is equal to KB into 1000 into W2 divided by M2 into W1. Here M2 is equal to 1000 into W2 into KB upon del TB into W1. Thus, in order to determine M2, molar mass of the solute, known mass of solute in a known mass of the solvent is taken and del TB is determined experimentally for a known solvent whose KB value is known. Depression of freezing point. Freezing point depression occurs when the freezing point of a liquid is lowered by adding another compound to it. The solution has a lower freezing point than that of the pure solvent. For example, the freezing point of seawater is lower than that of pure water. The freezing point of water to which antifreeze has been added is lower than that of pure water. As it is a colligative property of matter, it depends on the number of particles present, not on the type of particles or their mass. The freezing point of a substance may be defined as the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the substance in its liquid phase is equal to its vapor pressure in the solid phase. Let TF0 be the freezing point of pure solvent and TFB its freezing point when non-volatile solute is dissolved in it. The decrease in freezing point del TF is equal to TF0 minus TF is known as depression in freezing point. similar to elevation of boiling point, depression of freezing point, del Pf, Tf for dilute solution, ideal solution, is directly proportional to molality m of the solution. Thus, del Tf is proportional to m, or del Tf is equal to Kf times of m. The proportionality constant Kf, which depends on the nature of the solvent, is known as freezing point. The proportionality constant Kf, which depends on the nature of the solvent, is known as freezing point depression constant, or molal depression constant, or cryoscopic constant. If W2 gram of the solute having molar mass as M2 present in W1 gram of solvent produces the depression in freezing point del Tf of the solvent, then molality of the solute is given by the equation M is equal to W2 upon M2 divided by W1 upon 1000. Substituting this value of molality in equation 3, we get del Tf is equal to Kf into W2 upon M2 divided by W1 divided by 1000. Del Tf is equal to Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. And M2 is equal to Kf into W2 into 1000 upon del Tf into W1. Thus, for determining the molar mass of the solute, we should know the quantities W1, W2, del Tf, along with the molal freezing point depression constant. The values of Kf and Kb, which depend upon the nature of the solvent, can be ascertained from the following relation. Kf is equal to R into M1 into Tf square divided by 1000 into del Fh. Kb is equal to R into M1 into Tb2 divided by 1000 into del vapor H. Here the symbols R and M1 stands for the gas constant and molar mass of the solvent respectively, and Tf and Tb denote the freezing point and the boiling point of the pure solvent respectively in Kelvin. Further, del Fus H and del Vap H, further del fusion H and del vapor H, represents the enthalpies for the fusion and vaporization of the solvent respectively. Reverse osmosis and water purification. The direction of osmosis can be reversed if a pressure larger than the osmotic pressure is applied to the solute side. That is, now the pure solvent flows out of the solution through the semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis and osmotic pressure. Osmosis is the spontaneous movement of water across a semi-permeable membrane from an area of low solute concentration to an area of high solute concentration. Osmotic pressure. The pressure that must be applied to stop osmosis is called osmotic pressure. P is equal to ICRT, where P is equal to osmotic pressure, I is equal to Van 't Hoff factor, C is equal to molarity, R is equal to ideal gas constant, T is equal to Kelvin temperature. Abnormal molecular masses. Molecular masses can be calculated by measuring any of the colligative properties. The relation between colligative properties and molecular mass of the solute is based on following assumptions. First, the solution is dilute so that Raoult's law is obeyed. Second, the solute neither undergoes dissociation nor association in solution. In case of solutions where above assumptions are not valid, we find discrepancies between observed and calculated values of colligative properties. These anomalies are primarily due to, first, association of solute molecule, second, disassociation of molecules. Association of solute molecules. Certain solutes in solution are found to associate. This eventually leads to a decrease in the number of molecular particles in the solutions. Thus, it results in a decrease in the values of colligative properties. Colligative property is proportional to 1 upon molecular mass of solute. Therefore, higher values are obtained for molecular masses than normal values for unassociated molecules. Dissociation of solute molecules. A number of electrolytes dissociate in solution to give two or more particles. Therefore, the number of solute particles in solutions of such substances is more than the expected value. Wentorf's factor I. In 1886, Wentorf introduced a factor I called Wentorf's factor to express the extent of association or dissociation of solutes in solution. It is ratio of the normal and observed molecular masses of the solute. I is equal to normal molecular mass divided by observed molecular mass. In case of association, observed molecular mass being more than the normal, the factor I has a value less than 1. But in case of dissociation, the Wentorf's factor is more than 1 because the observed molecular mass has a lesser value than the normal molecular mass. In case there is no dissociation, the value of I becomes equal to 1. Since colligative properties are inversely proportional to molecular masses, the Wentorf's factor may also be written as I equal to observed value of colligative property divided by calculated value of colligative properties, assuming no association or dissociation. I is equal to number of particles after association or dissociation divided by number of particles before association or dissociation. Introduction of the Wentorf's factor modifies the equations for the colligative properties as follows. Relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to P degree A minus PA upon P degree A is equal to IXB. Elevation of boiling point del TB is equal to IKBM. Depression in freezing point del TF is equal to IKFM. Osmotic pressure N is equal to IN in RT divided by V. N is equal to ICRT. From the value of I, it is possible to calculate degree of dissociation or degree of association of substance. Degree of dissociation. It is defined as the fraction of total molecules which dissociate into simpler molecules or ions. Alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by M minus 1, where M be the number of particles in solution. Degree of association. It is defined as the fraction of the total number of molecules which associate or combine together, resulting in the formation of a bigger molecules. Alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by 1 divided by M minus 1, M, where M is equal to number of particles in solution.